A couple weeks ago, two of my friends invited me to New Zealand during the middle of uni. At first, I was unsure, but who am I kidding? I'm always down for an adventure. We packed our bags and left. We had 72 hours to make the most of our time. First stop, Church of the Good Shepherd.
We're sleeping for like 2 hours right now until the sunrise. This is like hour four into New Zealand. Good night.
After witnessing an amazing sunrise and running on 2 hours sleep, we made our way to Mount Cook. We were 9 hours into our journey, and the weather took a turn for the worst.
Man, the weather's absolute shit here. We're trying to run from it. God damn, can't even see the mountains. We're just gonna try to do our best. Overall.
Then checked into our accommodation to get some rest. And then we slept for 2 hours because I forgot to set the alarm. But in no time at all, we spent our 14th hour exploring Mount Cook. There is a swelling storm, and I'm caught up in the middle of it all. And of the person that I thought I was, the boy I used to know. There is a light in the dark, and I feel its warmth in my hands, in my heart. Why can't I hold on? It comes and goes in.
We are in the Tasman glacier right now.
Bloody hell.
This is an insane freaking view.
On the 17th hour, and with the light fading, we made it back to our hotel. We feasted on instant noodles in preparation for our 4 a.m. wake up to try catch the sunrise and hope for better weather. It's safe to say, we didn't see a sunrise. After a grueling 4 hour hike, we were met with rain, snow, and more bad weather. We were determined to make the most of our time in Mount Cook before we left for Queenstown, a 3 hour drive. On our 32nd hour, we were hoping for a change in the weather. Finally, things took a change for the better. Painting you a picture of the feelings that you never did. Oh, oh, oh.
A bit of an L, and the luge just closed when we got to the thing, so we're gonna go plan B, catch the sunset, see how it is. And yeah, man, a bit of an L, but we'll bounce back.
Before before we knew it, we spent our 41st hour in Fergburger.
Cheers!
One of the most iconic restaurants in Queenstown. We then had an early night's sleep in preparation for the sunrise the day after. We were then determined to get back on the luge. And here's what happened. I woke up pissed off today. Lately everyone feels fake. Somewhere I lost a piece of me. Smoking cigarettes on balconies. But I can't do this alone. Sometimes I just need a light. If I call you on the phone, need you on the other side. So when your tears roll down your pillow like a river, I'll be there for you. You gotta be there for me too. After a crazy morning, we finally made our way to Wanaka in preparation for a 6-hour hike. We only had 12 hours left in New Zealand. This is how we spent it. But I made it with you next to me. Around the world and back again. I hope you're waiting at the end. But I can't do this alone. Sometimes I just need a light. If I call you on the phone, need you on the other side. So when your tears roll down your pillow like a river, I'll be there for you. But you gotta be there for me too. And that's it. 72 hours in New Zealand coming to an end. We finished up on our 6-hour hike with some of the most unforgettable views I've ever seen. Thank you Kevin and Kevin for the amazing trip. But until then, see you in the next adventure.